joy. You are my song. You are the well, the one I'm drawing from. You are my refuge, my whole life long. Where else would I go? Surely my God.
Good morning, Heart Lake Baptist Church. Good morning to anybody who may be watching this on our live stream. We are really excited to be here with you. I want to begin by asking you a question. What is your week been like? Have you had a good week? Have you had a bad week? Have you had maybe a horrific week? You know, many times, many of us, we go through times in our lives that are very, very difficult. Yes, there's times of joys, and then there is times of sorrow. But God's desire is that we come to his service. If you're watching this live or you're watching this at home, sitting on your couch in your pajamas, God wants us to rejoice, to honor him, to give him praise. And we all go through times of sorrow. We all go through moments in our lives that seem so difficult, that it seems like when we are looking in the tunnel, we cannot see the light there. That we may be walking through the valley of the shadow of death, and yet we feel like we're never going to get to the end. David felt like that often in his life, where he had walked away or just circumstances with Saul attacking him all the time and with other things going on in his life. But Psalms 103, the first five verses, this is David, in a sense, speaking to himself and declaring who God is. And I want to read that to you. And it says this. So Psalms 103, verses 1 to 5. And it says, "Praise the Lord, O my soul. All my inmost being, praise his holy name. Praise the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits, who forgives all your sins and heals all your diseases, who redeems your life from the pit and crowns you with love and compassion, who satisfies your desires with good things so that your youth is renewed like the eagles." This is David speaking to himself, and I think we need to speak those words often to ourselves, because we may be down and discouraged, and maybe our first thought isn't to go on to our knees and praying or open up our scriptures. But we must tell our souls, "Praise the Lord, O my soul." Let us pray. Father, you are majestic. You are holy. You are wonderful. You are our healer, our counselor, our advocate. There is no reason, Father, for us to ever, ever trust anything else but you. And I pray, Father, that our heart's desire, that every member of our church, every person watching this video will be reminded of your goodness and your love, that they may be reminded of the things that you have done in their lives, that maybe just for a moment they may have a bird's eye view of their life and see how you have moved in their life throughout, even before they were even saved. I pray, Father, that we may have a focus on you. And today, as we come to this service, as we worship together, as we hear God's word, may we be transformed by your love, by your power, by your word. May we learn to live according to your word and not just be seers, as James talks, but doers of the word. That we may see the reflection in the mirror of ourselves and not forget when we walk away. We thank you, Father, for this day. For you are a magnificent God, and we hand this service over to you. We ask you that you transform us by your Spirit. In your mighty name we pray. And the people of God said, amen, amen. So welcome to everybody who is watching us online. You are missed here at the church. We really do miss you so much. We do hope that you're having an awesome week and that the Lord, that you know that the Lord is working in your lives in a daily basis. So welcome. So I would encourage you at this time, text somebody out there, somebody who may need a word of encouragement, somebody who needs to be celebrated. And I actually want to tell you about one individual who is actually needs to be celebrated. And for you who attend our church, you'll know who it is, and I'll just mention him by first name. And his name is Taryn. And Taryn is, his birthday is today, or this week, and he's actually turning 14 years old. Now, I love youth, and I love kids, and he was in my kids program, and he grew up. Now, I miss him so much in our kids program. But I want to say happy birthday to Taryn. He's an absolutely awesome young man. I know we usually don't do stuff like this from the podium, but I saw that it was his birthday and I had to say something. So Taryn, happy birthday. We do miss you so much and I can't wait until I see you again. So happy birthday. So you know what? Somebody send him a text message. Send him a, just a, call him on the phone. You know that thing that rings and it's connected to the wall. Call him and, you know, just to say happy birthday. It is a wonderful thing to do. But text somebody else out there. Amen. Also, I want to say thank you so much to everybody who continues to give to our church faithfully. It is a wonderful, wonderful testimony. It makes us here at the church rejoice to see the people of God, so many of you who actually come and you give of your offerings, you give, and you've been faithful throughout this year and a half that we've been in the pandemic. So thank you so much for that. So let's take a moment. Let's pray, even if there's any people who are struggling financially. Let's pray for those people even now. And let's thank the Lord for everything that is coming in. We thank you so much, Father, because our trust is in you, that you've helped us, Father, but that by your Spirit we're able to come before you, trust you. Father, we come humbly but yet boldly, knowing that you are our Father, that you've adopted us into your family, that we are loved by you. Father, I thank you for every penny that comes in. And like I ask every time I pray, Father, may we use it according to your ways. May every penny be stretched to absolute max so that we may reach the people in our community, the people in our lives, people who are meant to be here in our church. I thank you, Father, for your faithfulness and your love. Father, if there's anybody in our church who may be struggling, even at this time, it would be with work or just being able to put a meal on their table, I pray, Father, that you meet their needs. That, Father, that you reach them at the place that they're at. And if there's anything in our church as individuals that we can do to help other people, to love on them, to care for them, to help them out, help us to see, to open our eyes. And we thank you, Father, for your faithfulness in our church. In your mighty name we pray. Amen. Amen, church. Church, check out our heartbeat, and also we do have a special video immediately after our heartbeat.
Hello there, Heartlake Baptist Church. Welcome to our Heart Lake Heartbeat, where you get all the information of what's happening in our church in 2 minutes or less. Now, yes, you're probably wondering, what is happening behind me? Guess what? We are repairing the roof. You guys donated for our Easter fundraiser, and now we're able to fix it just in time. Do you know why? Because on July the 4th, we are probably going back to in-person services. I am so excited. We're going to be able to glorify our God together once again. Now, you do have to go online and register the week before, each and every single week, so that we know exactly who's coming and that we have enough seats for you. Second, PLUS is looking for their Ride for Refuge coordinator that is going to head their team. So we want you to pray about it, see if you would consider actually being part of that team, if you want to be the coordinator, and then we will get that information. Go to our website and fill out our Connect card and say, I want to be a coordinator, and we will get that information to them. Also, kids camp registration is coming. You got to go to our website, kids. Nag your parents, grab them, pull them to the computer, and tell them that registration for July the 4th is our first week of our 7 weeks of camp. Now, each week you can register your kids. You can register them every single week. I am so excited for camp. And finally, I want you to check out this video. Now, we have Dave and Eleanor Copping, who have been part of our church for a very long time. Usually, we do this in person. We want to celebrate them, as Dave will be moving on from our church. The Lord is calling them out. So we want you to check out this video as we say thank you for the whole time that they were here. Church, have a great day.
Good morning, church. We'll be reading our scripture today. Our scripture is from Isaiah chapter 1, verse 10 to 17. Hear the word of the Lord, you rulers of Sodom. Listen to the instructions of our God, people of Gomorrah, the multitude of your sacrifice. What are they to me, says the Lord? I have more than enough of burnt offerings, of ram, of the fat of fattened animals. I have no pleasure in blood of bulls and lambs and goats. When you come to appear before me, who has asked of this of you? This tramples of my court. Stop bringing meaningless offers. Your incense is detestable to me. New moons, Sabbath, and conversations. I cannot bear your worthless assembly, your new moon feasts, and your appointed festivals. I hate all with my being. They have become a burden to me. I am weary of bearing them. When you spread your hands out in prayer, I hide my eyes from you. When you are Even when you offer many prayers, I am not listening. Your hands are full of blood. Wash and make yourself clean. Take your evil deeds out of my sight and stop doing wrong. Learn to do right. Seek justice. Defend the oppressed. Take up the cause of the fatherless and plead the case of the widow. Thank you.